Hi everyone, it's Bea Divine and welcome to Divine Miracles channel, and thanks for joining me for the messages for the month of May. And already it's hit us pretty fast and pretty hard. I would have been with you yesterday, however I had a interview on Sunday night, and it was between 1 and 3 o'clock in the morning. And you know, when you finish something really exciting like that, you can't sleep. So all my sleep was out of whack yesterday. So I'm here today to do the messages for you, and I will post that interview as well. And apparently we only got half of the interview recorded, which would be right, wouldn't it? I will post that anyway for you guys, so you can hear it, because it was quite cool. So for the month of May, working with the angel Ambriel, who's known as the Prince of Thrones, which is one of the orders of angelic hierarchy. So you've got all these different choirs in which the angels reside, and of course that's just what people have categories people have put them in. But anyway, he is known throughout many different texts as the Prince of Thrones, which is interesting because, you know, just at the end of April we've lost Prince himself. So maybe there's a message there for all of us. So I'm going to go through the different things that are going to be happening for the month of May. And of course, this is only a guide for all of you. Everything can change. Decisions that you make can change things. But I'll just do my best to guide you through some of the things that I felt was happening. And I'm really, really glad it is May, because it is the 7th birthday for Divine Miracles being online, and obviously 26 years for me doing this kind of work. And I'm hoping there's going to be some changes in this year for all of us. And I do know that I've got a few things that I'm working on. Hopefully they can all come to fruition, and I'm sure that a lot of you guys are working on some different things as well. And May is the month for things to be happening quite quickly, and you probably already noticed a change in energy. As soon as it hit the 1st of May, things started to change, and this is really, really good because we've been building ourselves up to the different energies so far this year, and we've been going through the peaks and the valleys of our emotions and of our finances, and, you know, just life situations where everything seems fine and suddenly it's down, and everything seems fine and suddenly it's down. People coming and going, and in the month of May there's going to be changes again in directions. Maybe there's going to be people that are leaving us. There's going to be a difference in you energetically. And this is what happens when we change energetically, or we shift in our spiritual growth. Then we start, you know, losing people that maybe once were our friends or our co-workers, you know, people that we've known for a long time, because we just sort of don't fit in anymore. We don't fit into, you know, what they're doing in their lives, because we've changed ours so completely. And even though you may have friends for a very, very long time, and you know, like myself, I've got friends that I've known for a very, very long time, since I was a teenager, and I wasn't doing so much spiritual work back then. I was giving readings for people and things like that, but I wasn't doing it, you know, wholeheartedly because of life circumstances. And then when I started Divine Miracles, you know, 7 years ago, those same people were just like, oh, you know, what does she think she's doing, and who does she think she is, and all of this, why would she know anything? And, you know, they, even though they haven't said it, although some people have said it to me, even though they haven't said it outwardly, you can sort of tell, because they don't follow anything that I do, and they, you know, you couldn't talk about it. We couldn't sit at the table and have a cup of tea and talk about anything spiritual, because they just don't do that. So you'll probably find that your interests change, people that are in your life change, people that have been in your life change. And this is not such a bad thing, you know, because after all, we want people that are on the same wavelength as us, and that we can grow and change with, and who are going through the shifts that we are. And this is especially true with relationships as well. You know, sometimes you just outgrow relationships because, you know, you're doing too much growth, and, you know, they're staying in one place, and, you know, it just doesn't feel right, and you just can't live like that. So Ambriel is bringing in that energy of fast movement, of things happening quickly, life changing, the direction of your life changing. As some people will be traveling in the month of May, and just moving on and moving away from anything that's been holding you back in the past. So I've got some notes and I've got some things about Ambriel, and I'll just read them to you as we're going along. So again, the key notes for the month of May is change, direction, skills, fast action, abundance, flow, energy healing, and sudden moves and travel, with them basic key points. And the gemstones that can help you to connect with Ambriel and this energy of fast action is citron, peridot, tiger's eye, agate, and clear quartz as well. And the oils, essential oils, which I really love to use, are juniper, cypress, lemon, and patchouli. And you can make a mix of those, perhaps using jojoba oil, or, you know, even though it's not that great, but you could use olive oil if you didn't have anything like that. And you could mix these into a mix and anoint yourself with them. You could run some hot water and put a cloth in the hot water and some of these drops of the essential oils in there, and sort of make a compress for yourself. And it helps you to feel uplifted and helps you to feel in connection with Ambriel. You could probably even make a mix and dedicate it to the angels in that way. So we're going to go over the different elements too, and a message for each one of you. And again, I'm going to use these energy cards for us. I'll try to use them on the monthly guidance so that, you know, we can look forward to using them, because I never know what's going to come out because they're quite new to me. And I'll do a message from Ambriel and the angelic realms for us as well. And all this will be written up at my website. So if it's not there right now as you're looking at this video, just give it a day or so and refresh your browser and it will be there. And you basically just go into my homepage and you can click on the link for my articles and then you'll see it. So I'm going to go through, first of all, just wanting to talk about a little bit more about these keywords as well. We've talked about the changes and direction, things moving quickly, and sudden movement and travel as well for some people. But we've also got abundance and flow and energy healing and your skills as well. So we've been working on having a higher awareness. We've been working on, a lot of us have been doing meditations at night. Perhaps you've been listening to music and meditating with that music as well. And we're going to start seeing the changes that this brings, because whatever is most predominantly on our mind, then we are bringing about in our life. So if you're thinking or focusing on yourself as being successful and being abundant in every way, and I'm not just talking about in a monetary sense, but abundant with things around you and, you know, people around you and, you know, happiness and joy and all of those things, then you're going to start seeing the effects of that and the effects of the way of your thinking. I can't get words out today. And the energy healing as well. So energetically, we're all energy, obviously, and everything around us is energy. Angels are the energy of unconditional love. And we're working on healing the different parts of ourself, the different places within our body that have built up stagnant energy. And generally, a stagnant energy pocket is a deep-seated emotion that, you know, you haven't been able to release. Whenever someone's doing or coming to me to see me about healing, or I'm talking with them about healing, I always like to get to the bottom of the emotion and of what they're really thinking and what they're really feeling, because sometimes an emotion that you're not even aware of, something that you've been doing for a long time, something that you've been thinking for a long time, is the very key to your complete surrender and your complete acceptance of healing. Every single one of us is a healer, and that just means that we have this intention within us of healing, and that if we focus our intention of healing within ourselves or with other people, then that can come about. And everyone's got this, and I do try to encourage this as much as I can. So you may be working on different pockets of emotion within yourself and probably have been for some time, But we want to get to the bottom of, you know, the recurring thoughts in your mind, because that is doing the most damage. Those thoughts that nobody else knows about, nobody else realizes that you're thinking, and those ones that have been there with us for as long as we can remember. Now, all of us immediately are thinking of something that we only know about and that we've only thought of. That can be so damaging to us energetically if we don't just release it. And it's a matter of catching ourselves in a train of thought. It's a matter of catching ourselves when we're feeling that way and keep on releasing it until you don't have that experience anymore. So this energy healing is very, very strong this month, and it's a really good idea to have a focus this month on your thoughts and writing down, you know, your innermost thoughts, the ones that you don't talk about, the ones that you don't tell anybody about. And you'll probably find that a whole lot of memories start to come up with those, you know, in reaction to those thoughts. So for example, you know, because I'm just quite an open book, I'm going to put myself out there a little bit. In my life, I've been abused since I was a very young person. And, you know, in my life, I've had this abuse going on in family and everything. Not my real dad, but my stepdad and my mother were terribly abusive to myself, especially. And because of that, I felt that not only was I not good enough, but there must be something terribly wrong with me in order for these things to happen to me. I'm not just talking about physical, but sexual abuse as well. And I always felt that there must be something that I was doing in order to cause this or attract this type of attention towards myself. So when I was young, when I got away from the situation, I'd been in the situation until I was nearly 13, since 5 years old, and I got away from the situation and went to live with my dad, I suddenly just said to myself, well, I'm not going to be a victim anymore, which was a good thing. And I am going to change completely my appearance so that I'm not, men or older people are not attracted to me anymore. So I turned myself into looking like a boy and basically became a tomboy with really short hair, you know, boys' clothes, baseball caps, everything, and spent my life straight after school and all the things that I was doing at a farm, working on the farm, working on horses, building fences, building barns, like all the boy stuff, and, you know, driving cars and all kinds of stuff like that. And I just completely decided that I'm going to not, you know, have that kind of attention towards me. So an emotion within myself is that I'm not good enough and I need to change myself and I need to be unattractive, which is funny because girls like to be attractive, you know. And we like to have the attention, obviously, and I did not want any of it. You know, when I finally came back to Australia and things changed for me, and I met the first person that was ever a boyfriend to me, I just accepted it because I thought, well, you know, this person's going to look after me, this person will protect me, this person's really tough, and they're not worried about what I look like, and they accepting me for who I am and all that kind of thing. And I sort of latched on to someone that was completely wrong for me, but still I did those things. And it's because of the innermost feeling within myself that there's something wrong, and I'm not good enough, and, you know, there's really something wrong with me, so I'll just be with whoever, because if they accept me, then they think that there's something good about me. And you know, that was something that was different for me, if that makes sense. So I have my own innermost thoughts that come up, even the way I am today, even though I'm confident and I'm strong and I'm, you know, positive and I've changed my life and, you know, I've worked on myself, sometimes there's this feeling within me that gets irritated when I feel within myself that I'm not good enough. I get this irritation that comes up. I get irritated around people that make me feel that way. And all of that stems from that. It's like a defense mechanism. So find the little emotion within yourself that only you really know about. Now, I've just told you something that no one really knows about me, that, you know, I get irritated when I'm around people that, who I feel think of me as not good enough, or who I feel when I'm around that I'm not good enough, you know, where I feel like there's some sort of, I don't know what the word is, anyway, just where I feel that I'm not good enough, or I don't meet the mark somewhere. Whenever I'm around someone like that, it is sort of a inner doubt within myself, so I probably project that a little bit. But with all the work that I've done on myself, I sort of doubt that, but maybe I do. And you know, I get that way, and I get that irritated feeling within myself, which I work on and push away and strengthen myself again. So there's something within you, I'm sure, that is a challenge. It's something that you've had there for a long time. It's something that nobody really knows about, or nobody really understands, or maybe people can sympathize, but they don't really get it completely. And you only know about that. So it's time to start writing those things down, writing them right out. Every little thing that you can think of to get rid of these pockets of energy and have this proper energetic healing that you know you are so worthy of. And remember that this process may take time, because it will take a fair bit of time to break down, you know, when the feeling first began and who made you feel that way and why they made you feel that way and why it repeats in your mind from time to time. And if we can conquer those things and we can really get over those things, then we can change completely, and, you know, our life will follow suit as well. So there's just a little bit of a story, I guess. Maybe it resonates with somebody out there, and if so, I'm glad that for that, because then you know that no matter what, you can get through it and you can be a completely different person than what you might have been, you know, 5, 10, 15, even 20 years ago. Completely different person. So, and you know, you can do anything you want. So let's have a look, what else? We've got the abundance, we've got the energy healing, and the flow. So going with the flow of energy instead of always sort of fighting against it. And we all get ourselves into a you know, time in our life when we feel like we're trapped, or we feel like we're stuck, or we feel like nothing's really happening, and then we start to panic about it. And it's in those moments of panic that we need to break ourselves free, and you know, say to us, no, it's going to be okay, I'm going to get through this, this is happening for a reason. And the self-talk will help you get through the flow, and also this feeling of you're being punished in some way when everything goes wrong. We've got to stop that within ourselves as well. So there's a whole lot of stuff going on for the month of May, but once we do these things, and you know, and we're going to be able to bounce through them a lot easier than we might have, say, at the beginning of the year, because the whole energy is different for May, and you know, it's going to be easier for us, and there's so many exciting things happening as well. So there we go. Those are the key points. I'm going to do the message as well from Ambriel. But before that, I'm going to do the Leo, Aries, Sagittarius star signs, which is the element of fire. And Archangel Michael is the overseeing angel for those star signs. And I'm going to pull one of these cards out. And well, I'm going to focus on the fire signs and a message for us all for the month of May. And I'm a fire sign, but only just. I'm at the end of Leo, but I do still kind of think it's cool that I've got the lion as my symbol. Right, here we go. Okay, so for those who are fire signs, this is our card. And it says here, appreciation. It's gorgeous, isn't it? All right, so let me just have a look at this because I need to focus on it. Okay, so we're being asked in this particular card, I'm going to hold it up for a little while so we can look at this. We're being asked in this particular card to appreciate all the little things around us. But not only that, appreciate ourselves and how far we've come on our journey. So this is a little bit of a pat on the back for you. It's also got this lady there, and you can see that some of the things in the garden do not look as lush as other things. So perhaps she's tended to things in her life, and looked after those things, but maybe that she's left some things behind. And perhaps that has a lot to do with, what we've been talking about with our innermost feelings and things. So perhaps on the surface, we're happy and we're smiling and we're joyful, and underneath there's still a lot of work to do. So just appreciate yourself in every single way and the beauty that resides within you, and not needing others' approval to do the things that you want to do, not needing other people's approval to be yourself and allow yourself to shine, even when others might not believe in you and what you're doing. So appreciation is going to come your way from other people, but more so that when you start appreciating yourself and tending to those things that you might have forgotten within yourself, you will start to see things really, really blossom and grow for you. So that's a lovely message for the fire signs or anyone else that says, hey, that's something I need to do. Okay, and then we're going to go on to the water signs, which Archangel Gabriel's overseeing water, and that's Pisces, Cancer and Scorpio. So oops, I'll turn these the right way so you can see me shuffling. There we go. Water signs. All right. Oh, now that was facing upwards when I went to shuffle. Okay, so we've got the sun. You got the sun shining on everything, and this lovely lady in the pool of water. Now let me just look for a moment. Oh, there's a baby there. So maybe somebody's about to have a baby, or you might be pregnant, or maybe there's some things that are fertile and coming into play. I also see there's a connection with music and creativity and animals as well. So maybe this is a month for you to really open up your creative abilities, and when you do that, you're able to focus on your goals or what inspires you instead of things that might be going wrong in your life. I also feel that this sun is talking about the sun shining in our hearts, or the there's this real feeling of joy coming for the month of May, and you're able to express yourself, I guess, a lot easier as well. In traditional tarot cards, the sun also represents a new location, which is we were talking about traveling as well, to a sunny place, a place that's sunny, or perhaps someone is coming from a place where there, it's really, really hot and dry, coming towards you, and it's going to be a joyful occasion. Obviously, there's a lot of, I'll just hold this up a little bit easier for you, maybe like that. Obviously, there's a lot of cleansing and a feeling of, just peace and obviously flow coming into your life. So maybe there is a big change where you've been having a lot of stress, and you're going to move more into quiet, peaceful type of life, which everyone says hallelujah for that. Okay, so that's the message for the sun, for the water people. The water people. All right, and the, what else we got? The air signs, which is Gemini, Aquarius and Libra. There we go, without looking at my sheet. And Archangel Raphael working with the air signs. So let's see what message you guys get for the month of May. Okay. We got financial constraints. Well, hallelujah. All right, let's have a look. Okay, so you guys have been sort of broke, sort of showing here that there's only a couple of pennies in the cupboard, and it's all cobwebs, so there hasn't really seen much action for a while. So this is a good thing that's come, this has come up, okay? Finances being really, really flat. Because that's happening now, at the moment, at the beginning of the month, it's like that's the end. You know, you're going to start noticing things changing. And part of that has to do with the way that you've been doing things. So you've been focusing more on abundance. You've been trying your best to save. You've been working hard towards things. You're trying not to worry when you see the bills coming in. And all of these efforts are going to pay off for you. There's a lot of healing coming towards you because you got Raphael working with you as well. So there's a lot of healing coming in all areas of your life. And I'm just getting the feeling that you just need to hang in there a little bit longer while things work themselves out a bit more. But learn from your mistakes. And, you know, if people haven't got any money now and you're lending all this money to them, then how are they going to pay you back? So you're learning lessons, you know, about who, I mean, it's lovely to be kind and charitable, but if you haven't got much for yourself, you know, maybe there's a lesson in that, you know, give when you can, but don't give so much that you have nothing for yourself, because that's just, you know, you're just leaving yourself stagnant and you're leaving yourself dry, and then you're going to start feeling resentful for giving away so much. Allow yourself to receive sometimes. You know, you don't have to give away all the time. And I know I am the biggest person for giving things away, and then, you know, I get myself all hectic inside of myself. So give when you can. Know that things are changing for you financially. And even though you've had this problem where, you know, the cupboard is bare, there's ways in which you're going to see changes in that, and you're going to see opportunities for yourself. So try not to focus on lack, but focus on receiving and abundance as well for yourself. So that's the message for the air signs. Okay, I'm starting to get the itches around here. Now we got the earth signs, Archangel Uriel working with the earth signs, and that is Virgo, Capricorn, Earth, Taurus. All right, I should know Taurus because that's Pete's star sign. So here we go. I'm just going to shuffle these and let's see what message we get for the earth signs. Okay. All right, what will it be? Okay, anxiety. Okay, so again, this could be because we're pulling this card out just at the moment. This is a message for what's leaving you, or what can come up for you. You know, what can come up if, you know, you let things get to you. So in this card, you know, she's really, really sad and she's been crying, and there's lightning outside, and it looks like she's been doing something like maybe punching walls or something with her hands and just feeling really, really stressed and concerned. And this is how many of us were feeling in February. Remember when it was a really, really tough month for so many people? And then maybe towards the end of March, you started noticing it as well, where you were getting yourself uptight and anxious. But another message that I'm getting with this is that you are taking on someone else's anxiety because you are so, you know, you've raised your energy levels so much, you've been working on your abilities and things, that your sense of empathy is so strong that you are taking on other people's emotions and feelings and things that are happening in their life, and it's feeling double towards you, you know. So in other words, when one little thing goes wrong in your life, it's going to feel like 10 things have gone wrong, the weight of it on your shoulders. So this card is saying, you know, just be careful that you are clearing yourself, making sure that you are, you know, working on yourself morning and night energetically, that you're clearing the energy, that you're taking good care of yourself, and that you are making sure that you're not taking on too much from other people as well. Maybe people have been putting a lot of extra responsibility on your shoulders. Maybe this is something to do with work and you're doing all these extra hours. Maybe you're minding all these children and it's like really, really difficult. Maybe the workload has just increased. Maybe you've been like myself and say, oh, I'll do that for you, and then think, how the heck am I going to do that? So just watch your anxiety levels. Anxiety comes from looking too far ahead into the future and starting to get yourself worked up. So try to stay in the flow, try to stay in the now, and know that, you know, you don't want to be anxious, you don't want to have those feelings, you don't want to get rashes all over your body or itching or sleepless nights or anything like that. You want to be in control, and this is a message to say that you can do it and that you're getting on top of it, and there's nothing to worry about. Everything is going to work out exactly, you know, how it should. And all you've got to do is take one day at a time and refuse to take on, you know, say no when you need to, refuse to take on other people's issues and their energy. Clear yourself and ask for shielding with Archangel Michael, and also talk with Archangel Uriel, who is the overseeing angel for the earth signs. Talk with Uriel about these different things, and he is like the psychologist angel, so he will give you solutions to your problems. So this is all going to change. Everything's going to change for you. So just be aware of those anxiety levels within your body. So there you go. There's the message for everybody for the entire month of May. But I'm just getting this calling to do one overall card for all of us. So I'm going to do this. Let's see what we get here. Okay. And stop. See, you just know when to stop. What have we got? Attachment. Have a look. Okay. Again, this is also sort of verifying some of the things that we've been talking about for the month. We're feeling these attachments to things, and we need to have that energetic healing within our body. Remember that people with their thoughts and, you know, their emotions and their words, even if you're not in the room, can attach themselves to your auric levels. And, you know, this affects you because it penetrates, you know, if you're not shielding yourself and you're leaving yourself wide open, you know, people's nasty words can attack you. And if you suddenly feel like really, really tired during the day, or you just feel really grumpy for no reason whatsoever, or you've got absolutely no drive or no ambition or no inspiration, or you're not sleeping very well, I can guarantee that you've had a psychic attack, and there could be attachments within your aura. Now, this is nothing that you can't clear yourself, okay? But we need to be aware of it now, because it feels like at times that us as spiritual beings are sort of under attack more than normal. Not just from other people, but from, you know, the powers that be and the governments and all those kinds of things, and we can take it all on board. So this is a special message for all of us to watch what we're attaching ourselves to cut the cords of, you know, that bind us to people and situations and problems and all of those things. Make a plight with yourself that every morning and every night you will imagine that you have a white pyramid of light around you, completely around you, and that all the angels of the universe are surrounding you as well. Do it in the morning when you wake up so you're protected all day, and do it in the evening when you go to sleep so you're protected while you're sleeping. I found that when I've been sort of psychically or energetically attacked by people, that it happens to me while I'm asleep, okay? And, you know, it's, I wake up and I feel like I've had the energy completely zapped out of me, and I feel like I've just, you know, I don't know, not slept for a week or something, and then I get terribly irritable and I just knock myself, and I know someone's attacked me during my sleep. So, and it's just an energetic thing. They can't physically hurt you unless you let them. It's just an energetic thing. They're putting their nasty words, they're putting their jealousy, they're putting their hate or whatever it is towards you for some reason. You could be picking up attachments even going shopping, because we are empathetic, you know, and we are sympathetic to people all the time. And we are energized beings, and we're like magnets to all the crap. So we need to be sure that we're putting more shielding around ourselves now, and getting really used to doing that. Not just thinking, oh yes, you know, I don't need to worry about it, but doing it every day anyway. And, you know, asking for all of the angels of the universe to be surrounding you, guiding you, protecting you through the entire process. So there's the message for us for May, that we all need to be extra vigilant in this. Take care of ourselves, you know, be good to ourselves, be kind to ourselves, and cut, just say, okay, Archangel Michael and all of the angels, please cut any ties or any attachments or anything that I don't need from around my energetic field. Look at that, I've gone all yellow. From around my energetic field, cut all that away from me, you know, and repair and heal my aura, and place me in a protective bubble of light, or a pyramid of light. And you can do whatever color you like, but white is always really, really good. And you know, give thanks for that taking place instantly. As soon as you've asked for something, it's taken place instantly. So don't doubt that. Even if you don't feel like there's any confirmation or anything happening, as soon as you've asked for something to take place, it's done. All right. We don't need to attach ourselves or worry. We just say, no, that's been done, and it is done. We need to keep everything simple, but take charge as well. So we've got an interesting month ahead. I'm going to do the message now for you guys for May, and because obviously the video just decides it's going to be really super long, but I can't help it. I don't want to miss anything out. Okay. So I'm going to talk to you all about the message from Ambriel here, and obviously from the angelic realms as well. Dear ones, with love, we angels surround you always. There is no need to fear this unconditional. I'll sit back like this. There's no need to fear this unconditional love. We love you no matter what you think you have done to make you unworthy of being loved. We support you always, whether you know it or not. We are there, holding the energy of your divine blueprint. But be aware that you are energetically changing, and because of this, you may not have the same interest as you once did, or want to be around some of the same circles of friends anymore. As your vibration lifts, so do your standards of what you feel is right for you. It is impossible for you to please everyone, yet you've been trying to for far too long. I can't get my words out. Let go of this need and focus each day on what is best and right for you. There's no need to compare yourself to others, as your journey is yours alone. We know some of you are just finding your feet, spiritually speaking, and have so many questions. Please ask for clarity, and we will embrace you and guide you forward. Just trust. Get ready for fast activity and travel for some, as you follow your intuition and prepare for changes that will surprise and inspire you. Believe in yourself wholeheartedly, for you are truly worth it. With blessings, Ambriel and the angelic realms. So you can see the comfort and care and safety that you've got with the angels around you. And, you know, Ambriel, who's not an archangel, it's, well, I guess you could call him Archangel Ambriel, it doesn't really matter. They surround you and they bring in the energy of unconditional love, helping to make adjustments into your life and letting you know that everything's okay, no matter what it is that you've been doing, it's okay. And oftentimes people find that, or they feel that they're going to be punished in some way, because that's what's always happened, you know. But people are the ones that punish us, you know. We punish ourselves, and other people punish us. And the angels don't look at us and think, well, you're doing that wrong, or you're not sitting in the right yoga pose, or I saw you, you know, telling that lie or whatever. They're not looking at you like that and, you know, ticking off in a big book all the naughty things that you've done. They just look at you with absolute love, honor, respect, you know, and they see you as a being who's doing the best that you can in a world that is such dense, harsh energy, and yet you're still kicking forward and you're beating this thing, you know, you're getting on top. And you are going to make a difference in the world with whatever it is that you choose to do. As long as you have the right intention in your heart, and as long as you are reaching out spiritually, whatever that means for you, you are always on the right path. And, you know, your happiness is like a gauge, you know, it is a guide for you. Wherever your happiest is, where you're meant to be. not thinking to yourself, well, I'll stay here because I have to do this and things will change. No, wherever you're happiest is where you're meant to be, and wherever you're happiest will make everyone around you happy as well. Because a lot of us think that, you know, we need to do what's right for our family or right for other people, but really we need to do what's right for ourselves, and you know, everything else will fall into place that much easier if we do that. So I'd like to thank you all for being a part of my journey and being here with the Divine Miracles channel, and also, you know, checking out my website and all the things that I've written. And you know, I really want to share with you so much more about my life and the things that I've gone through as well, but perhaps it just needs to go into a big massive book. But anyway, I will talk from time to time about the different things that I've been through, because now I understand why I've had to go through it, and that is to resonate with people out there, and you know, to help me to be a stronger person as well, to persevere and to get through things. And I really hope that I inspire you, or you feel okay now because you know someone else is going through it and they're, you know, doing something for themselves, and that you can do it as well and change not only your life but, you know, everyone's lives around you. And whoever you come into contact with, they are changed because, you know, you are there with them. So that's a beautiful thing. So thank you again. Don't forget to check out my website. There's all kinds of specials for the month of May. And also check out all social media at Divine Miracles, where you'll find me. And I look forward to connecting with you sometime. So thanks again. And until the next video, it's goodbye for now. Bye.